Want to level up your Google Calendar or interested in getting started with using it? Google Calendar is one of the most widely used calendar tools. You can connect Google Calendar with Notion Calendar, Outlook, Slack, Zoom, and more. In this video, we'll cover tips and tricks that will help you become a Google Calendar power user. Stay until the end for a set of free hex code colors that you can use to customize your calendar. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Our first tip is to use Google Calendar keyboard shortcuts. And it's very intuitive and easy to use these shortcuts because all you have to do is to type a question mark and you're going to get the whole list of shortcuts. So if we go ahead and type a question mark, you can see that all of these are possible keyboard shortcuts that you can use. And in particular, the views are really useful. So just simply using your numbers, you can go from day, view, week, view, month, view, and custom view. And the other thing that's very important is the C to create an event. And of course, you can delete the event by deleting it and so on. So all of these are very useful. And as you get used to it, you'll notice that you're using the same keyboard shortcut a lot, and then you'll start to learn them very quickly. So let's go ahead and try out, for example, if I'm on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then if we type C to create the event, you can see that it's easy to create an event. So this is a really handy way to move around your Google Calendar. And if you don't see that question mark, you can go ahead to the settings menu, go to settings, and then we can go to the part where it asks about the keyboard shortcut. So make sure that this is checked off. The next tip we have is how to add secondary time zones. So with Google Calendar, it's really useful when you're collaborating with others. So at the Organized Notebook, Anne and I might be at different time zones. So in that case, we can actually add both of our time zones to our Google Calendar. So if we go to the settings menu and go to settings, the display secondary time zone, and then as you can see, it's now set to Eastern European time, and I could put the label Anne. And once that's there, if I go here, I can see that this coaching session is at a good time for Anne, for example, because it's between 11 and 1 p.m. and so on. So as you can see, this is a really helpful way to see each other's time zones. The next tip we wanted to show you is that you can actually create events directly from your Gmail. So if we're in the Gmail, we just made the sample conversation here, and you can actually go to these three dots and create an event. So if some kind of email is not really getting resolved or you're trying to set up a meeting, you can now just directly create an event. And that event is actually going to now show the conversation history here. And you can, for example, now I could add it to team meeting like this and easily create a new event based on the Gmail and the email conversation. The next thing we wanted to show is that you can create public calendars that you can embed. So this is useful. For example, we have live events that we want to publish, then we could actually go here and go to settings and sharing. And as you can see, we have the calendar settings here, and we can actually check off this box to make it available to the public. And if you click OK, now it's basically shared everywhere, and you can get a shareable link. And you can also embed this calendar. So here you could actually embed this HTML code. You can even customize it with your colors and so on and how you want it to show up. And you can also, for example, take this URL of the calendar and embed it as a widget inside of Notion. So for example, if we simply pasted the link in, you could create an embed and it's going to show up like this. The next tip is that you can share your calendar. So let's say that we want to share the team meeting calendar. If someone else might be coming, we could go to settings and sharing, and we can actually add specific people or groups. So if you just click plus add people and groups, you can actually add people here and share it with specific people. The next tip we have is to turn on calendars of interest. So if you go to other calendars and click plus, you can actually go to browse calendars of interest. And here you can see that you can, for example, add your contacts' birthdays, your regional holidays, global religious holidays, even sports and phases of the moon. So this is very useful, for example, if you want to see the holidays in your particular country. So definitely make sure to turn on your regional holidays. The next really useful tip is that if you wanted to see a specific date range, you can simply drag. So let's say that we want to see only Wednesday and Thursday, we could just drag like this, or you could see from Sunday to Wednesday. So as you can see, this is a really handy way to move around your calendar as well. The other tip we wanted to share is that you can actually set multiple notifications leading up to the event. So if we, for example, wanted to remind ourselves of this coaching session multiple times, we can simply edit it and we can add a notification. So the notification is 10 minutes before the event. You could add another one, for example, hours, days, weeks before the event, so that you really don't miss out on this event. The next tip we have for Google Calendar is just to make different calendars based on different things. So as you can see, we went pretty far and now we have personal time, blog posts, coaching sessions, errands, family, fitness, live events, and so on. But by kind of breaking it down into these smaller chunks, it can be really easy to track what you need to do and what's coming up. So if we only wanted to see the blog posts, we could just check everything off, so that we can see exactly when those things happen, like this. So this is a really useful way to just see all of your calendars and see only what's relevant to you and have different views for that. And in order to create a new calendar, all you have to do is click the plus sign here and create new calendar. And you can simply name it, you can put the time zone, even a description, and then create it. The final tip we have is actually for customization. So as you can see, we have custom colors here for our Google Calendar, and we highly recommend adding custom colors so that it's kind of in the style that you want and the visuals that are pleasing to you. So if you go to, for example, here in the three dots for personal time, you can choose these default colors, but you can also go to plus add custom color and enter hex codes. And here's where our hex code might be useful. We're going to be sharing with you all a set of hex codes that we used in this Google Calendar that you can easily add here. And basically by changing the hex code here, you can add different colors. So just as an example, if we were to add a new calendar, create new calendar, and here you can even add an icon using emojis. So for example, if we paste it in like this, you could get a nice emoji, create a calendar. And once we have that calendar, we'll see it on this left-hand side. We can see new calendar here. So let's, as a sample, just add an event here with that new calendar. So we can click here. And now it just gave us a default color. But if we want to change this color, we can actually change it by saving here and going to the three dots and clicking the plus sign. And then we can actually simply change the hex code or even just drag this around. So let's say that if we wanted to find a nice color palette, we would recommend you to go somewhere like to coolers, and you can easily find some colors this way. Let's say that we want this sort of ash gray. So we could just copy this hex code. We could go to our Google Calendar and we can paste it in, save. So now we have this new color for this calendar. So we highly recommend you to just customize your colors this way and be sure to check out the hex code set that we share in this video. Thank you so much for watching. The free hex code set is in the description. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to let us know, and we hope to see you all in the next video.